Hi, so this is the low-res cookie jar, and I'm adding it as the cookie mesh, but I noticed that the names are not to my liking, so I'm supposed to go inside here, and oh, okay, that's not so let's just call this lid, call it jar, cookie jar, Bonnie, I have to do this again.
What you need to do is select the...
Oh, should I... Okay, so... Do I have to just hit this instead? Okay, there.
Yeah.
So that's the...
target. Because that's your low res.
So I'm going to hit add selected. Okay.
And then for your source mesh is your high res.
So I'm going to go and hit this. Make that...
Yeah. They need to be aligned.
All right, so
they need to be aligned. The
if you still have questions about your grades,
like the lid and
hold on to them until like I get down from the demo. I want to make sure that everybody's paying attention to it. Like I said, I will be reporting it. I do want you to take notes just so that you can make sure that you understand the concept of why I'm doing this stuff.
It needs to be like
but,
precise.
As far as like you know, following along, do it at your own risk. Because we don't have the like, people to come around and make sure, like,
high res is here.
Adam doesn't know himself, but we don't have the time to come by and make sure that everybody's staying with us completely along every step. So, I'm going to record this.
Corrected.
Don't be too loud of a grid. It should be
fine.
Over y'all.
And so that's.
Click on normal map.
So. Oh, yeah.
And then
just
change your format to Targa.
Oh, we usually use JPEG.
JPEG,
oh,
that's fine.
Go here, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, don't ask anything else.
This is where you're...
Wait, when I go to milestone... No, wait, this is here. I would go to... source images. And then I would just name it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Cookie... jar... and just...
Yeah, save.
Make it JPEG. Then I can hit save.
Okay, now scroll down.
And go to.
Alright, so let's go
ahead.
Try
that.
Oh, I think I need to. Oh, wait, it's already.
Oh, make sure you have both layers visible
whole
just in case.
Both layers right here?
Oh, yeah, then they're
fine. Sure, oh, we'll just hit bake. That should take a little while.
And if there's like some weird parts going on, just adjust them. And also the advanced options.
Yeah.
All right. So now
awesome.
We're recording. All right. So let's go over the ZBrush demo. So I'll say this at the beginning. I'm working on Windows. That's going to be important when it gets into certain stuff like Photoshop. I'll save whatever hotkey I'm doing, because I want y'all to get used to doing hotkeys, but I'll let you know, on Mac, when I say control whatever, it's actually for y'all command, all right? And it's for that for like a Photoshop. How many people actually have Photoshop and stuff? All right, hopefully everybody, you won't be using it. Today, I was going to go over the cookie jar, but really, Adam's already shown you like spotlight projection, right? Where you can actually put like an image over your object and drag over it or pull like information from that. Okay. Yeah. So I'm not going to really go over that. Really what I show with this is that you can use this for mask area and then just use that right there. It's more of like a concept because it doesn't really make like for a good project. So we'll move on. All right. What we're going to focus on is the cake and the pineapple. All right. So let's go through and I'm going to show you from start to end this right here, and then I'm going to go over like the major things that's going to help you knock this out. So we go right here, new, let's say. And let's go ahead and open up and work and demos there and the cake. And go over what you should be looking at for a blockout. I mean, like for what your blockout should be going into ZBrush and a couple concerns that you should be looking out for. Alright, so right here I kind of went through like a police lineup of like how I built this. I'm going to explain the reasons why. So first, we're doing the wedge of a cake. So obviously we'll probably just take only a sliver of a cylinder, but instead of just starting off with the default cylinder, which is 20 segments, I think I've popped this up to like 40 or 50 right there. Just give me more roundness right here and more stuff to work with. You can be a little more frivolous with your segments when it comes to stuff like this right here. So one thing I would suggest if you're doing a cake, just take like a high poly cylinder and work out from there. And then obviously I can cut off everything to the top. And then I picked out my wedge. Now, there's a reason why I picked it this way, right here. A lot of people, when they do their cake, they'll just kind of go right here and let's just go and select this right here. And delete the rest, or yeah, right here. So that's my cake right there. Delete that and call it a day. The reason why you don't want to do that is one of the things that makes ZBrush so powerful is to be able to sculpt and use symmetry. Well, it takes this idea of symmetry from your Maya scene. So, if my cake right here is at this weird 45 degree angle, I have no areas of symmetry right here. So you want to make sure that you're making your cut along one of the axes. So, do that right here. So instead, I just kind of went right here, select those two, just kind of work my way out until I got what I want. That looks about right. Right there. And then delete the rest. And then call it there. Right. So, again, you want to make sure that you're keeping this symmetrical because it's going to just make your life easy. And hopefully, my damn brain is not going off every 2 seconds. So, oh, it's bugs. Like, bugs just crawling. So, anyway, I extrude it down, and then the next thing that I want to do is actually bevel my outside silhouette edges right there. That, the reason for that is because when you go and start smoothing it, you don't want to lose your shape. So what's going to actually happen right here is inside ZBrush you go and it's smooth. As you can see, it's starting to collapse in on itself because there's nothing there to actually hold its shape, hold its profile. So, you want to go in and actually put bevels around the outside edges right there. So, when you go to smooth it, it actually holds its shape, but also smooths it as well. So, back on both of those. Right. So, the next thing that you want to do is also add edge loops throughout. The reason for that is, if we just kind of take this one thing right here, start smoothing it over and over. You may notice one thing. The areas where we have the bevel is getting tons and tons of geometry. Meanwhile, the areas that didn't have any edges is getting very little. And that's going to make sense once you start sculpting on it, because if you start dragging your sculpting tool across it, you'll get like a really nice crisp edge right here, but once you start getting in here, it's all almost look like a compressed JPEG image. It's going to be like all dotted and pixelated and all that stuff right there. That's because you don't have consistent geometry throughout your objects. Alright? So, what you want to do is actually just kind of evenly space out some of your end loops. So, once you actually start smoothing it, you're kind of getting a nice ratio of like geometry throughout the whole entire thing. So, smooth again. So we're kind of like, you know, we're still getting like a lot of geometry right here, but we're still kind of keeping that on the sides. And kind of quickly be able to do that right there. I just used my insert edge loop tool, but we can't use insert edge loop tool across tries. So kind of quickly get that done. I'm just going to go right here. Go to our multi-cut tool. And if you drag outside the object, multi-cut tool becomes a cleaver, and you can cut straight through an object.
Okay.
And all I did was just kind of section off all the triangles to this side right here. That way I can go quickly go.
We want to do some soften.
Multi-cut right there. I don't need 20, Jesus.
And then bake it again. So it's
all right. So
everything is still set.
Go right there.
Right?
Quickly
just
add just. All right.
No, you have it.
It's on
safe, just baking it.
So, any questions about those concepts? So again, you want to make sure one, you know, just because it's called block out, it doesn't need to be blocky, especially if we have something that's like, you know, really easy to make. Make it a little bit more high poly. Two, make sure that you're building it on axis, so you can use your symmetry tools. And then also evenly space out your geometry and make sure that you're putting in bevels or at least holding edges to hold the shape of your object so it doesn't crumple onto itself. All right, so what's up? Yes. Not smoothing edges. I just did insert multiple edge loops, and what it does is just it'll take whatever number I put into it. And then just evenly space them out and just kind of throw them in there. Alright, so good with that right there. Next thing I want to do is go into ZBrush. And I didn't, this is one of the default things. I just want to make sure that ZBrush wouldn't crash once I load it up with the video recorder. Alright, so I'm going to hit T and Control New, get rid of that. So Control N, where's your canvas? And we're just going to import a tool. And now get to wherever
we're going. Oh, you were trying to bake, right?
Bake.
That was originally.
Wait, nine?
Yeah.
Alright, we're just on loads out, ZBrush. And then reopen. And we're back. Alright. So we'll navigate back. Get my cake. Again. Hit T on the keyboard so I can go into edit mode. Get rid of that. And we'll all work from here. Now, if you want to have it take up more of your area, we can go right here and document it double, and that will resize it, make it a little bit bigger. But we do need to redraw out, so I'm going to hit T to clear the canvas, so Control N. And now, drag this out, hit T again. Alright, so now that I did that, I want to actually get my reference going. So, right now, if you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm just holding shift as I'm moving it around like this, and it's snapping it to the nearest axis so I can kind of lock it down. And then I'm just going to go right here to texture box, and import.
That's better.
And then,
what was the other question you had?
So, I think what's supposed to do? Okay, add spotlight right here. That way, kind of move it around.
Yeah. And then your normal maps. You know where you find your maps and everything?
Yeah. Because it's in the...
Well, that way I can just kind of see in the corner without having to grid all my like little place cards there. Because really, this is a top, front, or side view. It's a three-angle view, so I don't really need it to, like, you know, be a background reference image. And then I'll go ahead and see. Now, if you do choose to do this method, for you to be able to sculpt on your objects, you have to turn off one option. Right here, and brush, go to samples, and turn off spotlight projections. And what that means is now it's not going to try to take information from my picture. Right? So I can just kind of start sculpting on it.
Yeah.
Really don't.
Let's zoom for now.
All right. So now we did that. Let's go right here to geometry, and we're just going to divide a few times.